Good morning, good morning, good morning, and welcome to Double Portion Kingdom Ministry Sunday morning family and friends prayer call. I thank each and every one of you for being a part of what God is doing. The songwriter said he has won the victory. He has won the victory. So even in the midst of a pandemic, I want you to get that down into your system this morning, that he has won the victory. So because he's won the victory, each and every one of us, we have the victory. No matter what it's looking like outside, no matter what the environment's like, no matter what the president said, no matter what's going on in the country, because we walk by faith and not by sight. So from the redemptive work of our Lord Jesus Christ on the cross at Calvary, we already have the victory. So I don't want you to focus this morning on what it looks like, but I want you to focus on the victory. Keep your eyes on the prize. Even in the midst of what looks like a bad situation, and we know that all things work together for the good of those that love the Lord and that are called by his purpose. Well, once again, welcome, welcome, welcome to the Sunday morning prayer call. I am going to yield to co-pastor Paulette for the morning check-in, and we will go higher in worship.
And so the rest of our announcements go as such. Again, our contact information is PauletteX7@gmail.com. You can contact us there, send your prayer requests, your praise reports, any information that you need. We also want to inform you of our YouTube channel at PauletteX7. Make sure you are subscribed there so you can receive when this call goes live on YouTube. You'll have it there. You'll have it available. We have two save the dates. We want you to keep in mind that we have our Flock of Men monthly call. It's every first Thursday. Every first Thursday at 8 p.m., the Flock of Men get together. The next call will be on Thursday, August the 6th. We'll have you join us, the men. It'll be men only right here on the line at 8 p.m. And then our other announcement is our annual retreat that will be taking place in April 2021. The theme for this retreat is True Identity. You'll be joining us in Monroe, Louisiana at the Seeker Springs Retreat Center in Monroe, Louisiana, April 16th through the 18th. Save the date. Plan on meeting us there. Again, we want to thank everyone for sowing into Double Portion Kingdom Ministries. Everyone who has sown, we thank God for blessing the sower with the seed that sows the seed. And as Double Portion Kingdom Ministries, we have sown into other ministries and also into the needs of people. If you're on the line and you have a need, please email us that information, and we will see if we are able to meet that need right here. So we're going to go a little further, a little higher in prayer. I'm going to call for the Brooks to come forward. Oh, yeah. Let me remind you, we are doing communion on today, later on today. So if you can grab your cracker, juice, whatever you have there in the house. We had apple juice this morning. So apple juice, grape juice, something to be prepared for communion as we go forward. And so now we're going to yield to the Brookses. If you can come up, come off mute, let us know you're there to give us the scripture reading and pray our corporate prayer on this morning.
Amen, amen. Can you hear me?
Okay. I hear you now.
Okay, praise Lord. I just want to give y'all and God what you hear to our household. Yeah, you know, we all go through a lot of things in our life, but we have to realize that he's still first in our life. But the scripture will be reading from Ephesians 4 and 31. Ephesians 4 and 31. And it reads, "Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you." Hear and read, be a blessing to the reading. I mean, God bless the hearing and the reading of this word. Amen.
Amen. We're going to pray this morning. God bless you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we come to you, Father God, Oh, God, thanking you, Father God, this morning, God, before we even, Father God, oh, God, come to you, Father God, with any petition, Father. We want to thank you this morning, Father God, for what you've done this morning, Father God. Oh, Lord, we thank you, Father God, for touching us, Father God. Oh, God, with your hand, God, and woke us up this morning, God, in our right mind, Father God. For that alone, God, we want to say thank you this morning right now. So, Lord, right now, Father God, we ask as we lift up, God, these prayer points to you, Father. Oh, God, we ask right now, Father God, that you, Father God, we know that you are not a man, that you shall lie, God. And we know, Father God, whatever we ask, God, you told us, Father God, come boldly to the throne of grace, Father God. If we can obtain favor there. So, Lord, this morning, God, as we speak and we decree and we declare these prayer points to you this morning, God, we thank you, God, that we can come boldly, God. And we thank you, Father God, for being the author and the finisher of our faith. So, Lord, right now, God, we speak, Father God, right now, God. Oh, God, the prayer point, God, that we're lifting up for the people of God, God, to turn back to God in restoration to this land, God. We bless you this morning, God, for 2 Chronicles 7:14, Father God, as we stand on your word where you said, if my people who are called by your name will humble themselves and pray and seek your face, oh, God, and turn from their wicked ways, God, then I will hear from heaven, and you will, Father God, forgive us of our sins and heal our land, Father. We bless you, Father, for the healing of our land this morning. Oh, God, we thank you, God, as we speak and we decree and we declare restoration of our broken family relationships, Father. As we said, Malachi 4:6, God, we thank you, God, that you would turn the hearts of the fathers to their children, God, and the hearts of the children to their fathers. Oh, God, we thank you, Father God. Oh, God, thank you, Lord Jesus, this morning, God, as we decree and we declare, Father, people on this call will be delivered, set free of any bondage. As we send on your word, Psalm 34:19, even when bad things happen to the good and godly ones, the Lord will save them and not let them be defeated by what they face. God, we bless you this morning. Oh, God, that you, Father God, are the true deliverer, Father. So, Lord, we thank you as we decree and we declare peace in our land. Oh, God, as we send on Leviticus 26:6. Oh, God, where you said in your word that you will give peace in the land, God. And you, Father God, will, Father God, you we can lie down in our sleep, Father God, and none, oh, God, shall make us afraid, Father. We thank you, Father God, as you said in your word that you will remove, Father God, the beast from the land, Father God, and that the sword shall not go through your land. So, Lord, we decree and we declare, God, peace in our land. Oh, God, we decree and we declare comfort for everyone who is grieving a loss or a loved one. May the Holy Spirit guide us in peace and comfort, God, as we stand on your word this morning, Father God. We thank you, God, for peace, God, the peace that surpasses all understanding. Oh, God, and we stand on your word this morning that we embrace the pain and uncertainty of the process in our present season. For, God, we know, God, as you said, God, in Romans 8:18 and Romans 8:28, but no matter how hard they try, God finds no pleasure with those who are controlled by the flesh. Oh, God, and we know, Father God, oh, God, that, oh, God, every good and perfect thing come from you, Father God. And we know, Father God, that all things work together for the good of them who love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. So this morning, Father, we bless you this morning, oh, God, for the times of uncertainty this morning, God. But we know, Father God, you know all. You are Alpha and Omega, God. You are the beginning and the end, God. So we put our trust and our faith in you. So, Lord, today, Father, as we lift up, Father God, a decree and declare, Father, that we, no matter what the circumstances, walk in the spirit of love. Oh, God, that no matter what's happening, Father, we will stand on your word in 1 John 4:16. Oh, God, we have come into an intimate experience with God's love, and we trust in the love he has for us, God. God is love. And therefore, God, because you are love, we are love, Father God. Because, Father God, you created us in your own image, God. And for that alone, God, we say thank you, Father God. You said, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. So this morning, Father God, as we, Father God, your people, Father God, oh God, are your arms, your legs, Father God, oh God, your willing service, God, we will have love, God. And with loving kindness shall, oh God, we draw thee, Father God, and point them right back to you, Father. So
this morning, God, we lift up Pastor Sims, Father. Oh, God, his brother, Wilson, Father God, moving, transitioning from New Orleans to Houston. Favor with the doctors and facilities and services, Father God. Touch him, Father God. Touch, oh, God, our brother Wilson, Father God, with your mighty hand, God. Touch him like none other, Father God. You know him, Father God, every hair on his head. So, Lord, we decree and we declare, Father God, a smooth transition. We decree and we declare, Father, favor with the doctors and facilities and services. And we decree and we declare, Father God, total healing, God. We thank you this morning, God, as we lift up marriages to you, God. We decree and we declare the spirit of unity and oneness in every marital bliss, Father God. Restore the love, God. Restore the joy, God. Restore the laughter. To restore the peace, God. Restore the oneness, Father God. Oh, God. Oh, God, we decree and we declare, Father God, a threefold cord, as you spoke in your word, is not easily broken. So, Lord, we thank you this morning, God, that you, Father God, are the middle, God. You are the foundation that every marriage stands on. So, Lord, we thank you for that, God. We thank you, God, as we lift up those needing healing from addictions, God. Oh, God, we ask right now, God, whatever the addiction may be, God, oh, God, that you will, Father God, heal it at the root. Oh, God, the root issue, Father God. We decree and we declare right now that, oh, God, healing will start from the root, Father God. Oh, God, and whatever that root is, God, we cause it right now. Oh, God, and we speak to it and we say, God, now, dissipate in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, and we decree and we declare, Father God, that there will be no residue. Oh, God, we bless you this morning for total healing and total restoration, God. And we thank you for a mind of Christ, God. We decree and we declare, God, for every addiction, God, we speak to it. What is one of, oh, God, the families that we're in, Father God. Oh, God, even, Father God, friends of the families that we're in, God. We declare, Father God, the mind of Christ, God, and allow them to know, Father God, oh, God, that the addiction is not who they are, Father. Allow them to know, God, that they are still a child of God. The addiction, Father God, is just a thing that they have. So, Lord, we thank you this morning, high God, that there is nothing that we can do that would not cause you to love us. So, Lord, we bless you this morning. We thank you, Father God, as we pray for everyone experiencing any kind of illness related to this pestilence that, oh, God, that is in the land right now, and any other physical or emotional illness, God, we bless you this morning. And we thank you for those seeking employment and the entrepreneurs on this line. We thank you, Father God, oh, God, for what you said in your word, Father God. You say 1,000 may fall at our right hand, and God, 10 at our other, God, but none will come near us, God. So, Lord, we thank you this morning, Father God, oh, God, that you have covered us in your shield of protection. We thank you for the protection, God. We bless you for your blood this morning, your unwavering blood, God, your powerful blood, God. The blood will never lose its power, God. So, God, we thank you, God, as we lift up every petition, oh, God, on this line, God. We know, God, that you, Father God, are God who answers by fire. So, Lord, we leave them there, God, oh, God, and we cast every care upon you. So, Lord, bless everyone on this line, God. Bless, Father God, Pastor Don and Pastor Paulette, God. Bless this line, God. Bless what you have put in their hands, God. Oh, God, allow them to increase ever the more, God. Every need be met, God. Every want be met, God, for the kingdom of God. Thank you for the building of the kingdom, Father God, this morning. And thank you, Father God, for everyone on this line, God. We speak to peace, and we say peace be still this morning. We thank you for your word, and we thank you for what you're going to do this morning, God. Have your way on this line. It's in your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Everybody,
say amen.
God
is
so good. So let the church say
amen.
Yeah. Can I get a
witness?
Oh,
say amen.
For what his plans are. For what his word
says.
God is spoken.
God is spoken.
let the church say amen. Make this your response. Whatever he said, from the healing of your body to the raising of the dead, no matter how you feel or how your world is reeling, battle on through the night, cause you're gonna win the fight, even in the valley. Standing at your red feet, continue to say, but the help is on the way. My God is for me. I heard him. So let the church say, oh, lift your hands wherever you are and let the church say, hey, amen. Let the church say, God has spoken. Hallelujah. Let the church say, all we needed was a word from the Lord. We've got it so. Let the church say, oh, let the whole church say, God has spoken. Well, let the church say, let the church say, amen. Oh.
Amen, amen, and amen, church. Well, I'm here to give us our brief exhortation and communion. So if you have your elements, I want you to get your elements and have them handy, have them close by. Open your Bible to Isaiah chapter 61. Isaiah chapter 61 is where we're going to be for communion on this morning. Of course, we'll end in 1 Corinthians 11, but I want us to open in Isaiah 61. As we partake of communion in this time, we want to connect, have an uncommon communion. That's what I've been called to do. We're going to bring the connection, and where Jesus said, as often as you do this in remembrance of me. Even as we spoke about in the last few weeks, we're also acknowledging Holy Spirit and giving him access to move in our lives because of what happened at the cross of Calvary. So if you found Isaiah 61, I'm going to read verse 7 in our hearing. I'm in the Passion Translation of Isaiah 61, verse 7. It says, because you received a double dose of shame and dishonor, you will inherit a double portion of endless joy and everlasting bliss. Yes, you've called into the Double Portion Kingdom Ministries on this morning. You're being blessed by the dynamic duo of Double Portion. That's Don and Paulette. You have Don the pastor and Paulette the counselor. What a team. But on this morning, as we partake of communion, Holy Spirit wants us to know, the counselor in me is saying, no more MSG. MSG is mistakes, shame, and guilt. We've made some mistakes. We've had things that happened in our life that have produced shame, that have produced guilt, and it said a double dose of it, but that's okay. There is a double portion of honor and joy that is to come. If you look back up in Isaiah 61 at verse 1, you can see the Trinity of God. It says, the Spirit of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. So you have the Spirit, that's God, the Spirit of the Lord God, that's God the Father, is upon me. This is speaking of Jesus. So when we partake of communion, he's saying, do this in remembrance of me. Yes, of the Trinity, of the Godhead, of Jesus Christ. And because he came, we now have Holy Spirit to help us to do all these things that Jesus was anointed to do, that now we're anointed to do. So as I close, I want us to see that Jesus said, this is me. In Luke 4, when Jesus opened the scroll, he opened to this Isaiah 61 and he said, this is me, as he began his public ministry. So each and every one of us, we are to be Christ-like. This is who we are to be. We are to walk in a level of anointing, and not just an anointing, but a double portion anointing. So we're going to continue in Isaiah 61 at verse 1 out of the Passion Translation. It says, the Spirit of the Lord God Yahweh is wrapped around me because Yahweh has anointed me as a messenger to preach good news to the poor. He sent me to heal the wounds of the brokenhearted, to tell the captives, you are free, and to tell the prisoners, be free from your darkness. I am sent to announce a new season. It's a new season. I am sent to announce a new season of Yahweh's grace, a time of God's recompense on his enemies, to comfort all who are in sorrow, to strengthen those crushed by despair who mourn in Zion, to give them a beautiful bouquet in the place of ashes, the oil of bliss instead of tears, the mantle of joyous praise instead of the spirit of heaviness. Because of this, they will be known as mighty oaks of righteousness. That's who we are. We are to be planted by Yahweh as a living display of his glory. They will restore ruins from long ago and rebuild what was long devastated. That's what we talked about last week or a few weeks ago, that you are fruitful repairers of the breach. You're rebuilding these things. They will renew ruined cities and desolations of past generations. Foreigners will be appointed to shepherd your own flocks. Strangers will cultivate your fields and tend your vines. Then at verse 6, these are who we as Messiah's ministers are to be. But you will be known as priests of Yahweh and called the servants of our God. You will feast on the wealth of the nations and revel in their riches. Verse 7, I'm switching over to the Amplified. It says, instead of your former shame, you shall have a twofold recompense. Instead of dishonor and reproach, your people will rejoice in their portion. Therefore, in their land, they shall possess double what they have forfeited. Everlasting joy shall be theirs. So as we go forward into this time of communion, I want you to receive the bread of healing, healing of any emotional wounds, any emotional hurts. I want you to receive healing according to Romans 12, 1 and 2, healing of your mind, will, emotion, intellect, thoughts, reasoning, imaginations. All of that is going to receive a realm of healing as we go forth in communion. Take and receive healing for the generations and release the power to be fruitful repairers of the breach. Eat and drink the double portion anointing of God. So now if you will grab your elements, we're going to decree in our hearing, 1 Corinthians 11, verse 23 through 26 in the Passion Translation. This was Paul telling of the revelation, firsthand revelation that he had. That's why we always pray, God, give us revelation, illumination, knowledge, insight, wisdom as to understanding your word and our purpose. And so Paul said here that I have had handed down, he said, I have handed down to you what came to me by direct revelation from the Lord himself. The same night in which he was handed over, he took bread, so get your bread, and he gave thanks. And then he distributed to the disciples and said, take it, eat your fill. It is my body, which is given for you. Do this to remember me. And so I want us to take the bread that was broken. Go ahead and eat of the bread. Eat of the bread, we're at verse 24 of 1 Corinthians 11. Keep going on to verse 25. It said he did the same with the cup of the wine after supper. And he said, this cup seals the new covenant with my blood. Drink it, and whenever you drink this, do it to remember me. And they did drink. And then verse 26 says, whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are retelling the story, proclaiming our Lord's death until he comes. And I want us to know on this month that whenever you eat this and drink this, you are retelling the Isaiah 61 story of being the anointed for such a time as this. We will go forward and look at the love of God that's flowing because of what he did for us on Calvary. That's love, what the Lord has done for us. God, we thank you and praise you for this time of communion, and we give you access to speak to our hearts as we go forth in worship.
For God so loved the world that he gave his son, that whoever believes in him will live forever.
Jesus went to Calvary, stayed a wretch like you and me. That love,
everybody sing out, Jesus.
The psalmist said, he laid down his life for us on a hill called Calvary on an old rugged cross. They hung him high and stretched him wide. But that's not how the story ends. On the third day, he rose. He rose for you and he rose for me in fulfillment of the scriptures. And that's why, people of God, this morning, that no matter what it looks like on the outside, we already have the victory in Christ Jesus. Well, there is a word from the Lord this morning. If you will go with me in your Bibles or on your electronic devices, go with me to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 11, verses 7 through 8, the book of Jeremiah, verses 7 through 8. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verses 7 through 8. And I want to do a quick shout out. My friend, my sister from another mother, Minister Vanessa Parker, all the way from Little Rock, Arkansas, is on with us. Good morning, Wisdom and Pearls Ministries, Little Rock, Arkansas. Amen and amen. Jeremiah 17, 7 through 8, and I'm going to be reading from the English Standard Version this morning, and it reads as such. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. He is like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream and does not fear when he comes, for its leaves remain green and is not anxious in the year of drought, for it does not cease to bear fruit. That's good news to somebody. The Message Bible translates it this way. But blessed is the man who trusts me, God, the woman who sticks with God. They're like trees replanted in Eden, putting down roots near the rivers, never a worry through the hottest of summers, never dropping a leaf. serene and calm through droughts, bearing fresh fruit in every season. The grass withers and the flowers fade, but the word of God will stand forever. Let's go to God in prayer this morning. Father God, we come to you this morning, first and foremost, God, just to say thank you. God, we come to lift you up because you said if you be lifted up, that you'll draw all men to you. So God, we come to lift up the name of Jesus on this morning. Now, God, I pray in the name of Jesus, if there be anything in me that's not like you, God, you burn it up with your consuming fire right now in the name of Jesus. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, God. I pray, God, anoint me a fresh filling of your Holy Ghost because I can do nothing without you, but all things through Christ who strengthens me. God, I pray that you anoint your people's ears to hear what thus says the Lord this morning. And God, I pray that each and everything that's said and done on this line is done to bring glory to your name and to edify the body of Christ. And the people of God say amen and amen and bless God. Hallelujah this morning. Well, I'm going to speak to you this morning for a little while from a sermonic subject of blessed to be a blessing. We're blessed to be a blessing. Amen. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed. And the Amplified says, happy, fortunate to be envied is the man who trusts and takes refuge in him. Trusting in the Lord that in all times, he sustains and blesses us with love, peace, joy, and hope everlasting. The Lord is faithful in times of prosperity, but he's also faithful in seasons of uncertainty, and he's even faithful, people of God, during pandemics. Amen? Jesus Christ, the Messiah, is always the same, yesterday, today, and forevermore. So I came this morning and stopped by to tell you that we can endure the times when storm winds blow because we ride through them securely beneath the shelter of the Lord's almighty hands. So be content with who you are and don't put on airs because God's strong hand is on you this morning. He'll promote you at the right time, live carefree before God. He is most careful with you. Jesus said it this way, my Father who has given them to me is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hands. The psalmist said, the Lord says to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool. Isaiah said it like this, don't panic, I'm with you. There's no need to fear. I'm your God. I will give you strength. I will help you. I will hold you steady, keep a firm grip on you. So this morning, we have confidence because we've experienced it time after time. God comes to rescue us and deliver us from whatever it is we're dealing with. In the book of Luke, it talks about one day, Jesus said to his disciples, let's get in the boat and go across to the other side of the lake. So they set sail. Soon Jesus fell asleep. The wind rose and the fierce wind became a violent squall that threatened to swamp their boat. So the disciples woke up Jesus and said, Master, Master, we're sinking. Don't you care that we're going to drown? With great authority, Jesus rebuked the howling wind and surging waves. And instantly they stopped and became smooth as glass. Then Jesus said to them, why are you fearful? Have you lost your faith in me? Shocked and shaken, they said with amazement to one another, who is this man who has authority over the winds and waves that obey him? So I come to tell you this morning, people of God, as we navigate through these uncharted waters of this pandemic and social disgust, Jesus is on your boat. Amen? He is on your boat. He already told the disciples, let us go over to the other side. So he was literally saying, we're going somewhere. I'm taking you somewhere. And as long as I'm with your boat, I don't care what these winds, I don't care what this storm of this pandemic looks like, I am with you wherever you go. You know, he said, little children, you can be certain that you belong to God and have conquered them. For the one who is living in you is far greater than the one that is in the world. And that's good news for somebody. The psalmist said, I sought. The Amplified says, inquired of the Lord and required him of necessity and on the authority of his word. And he heard me and delivered me out of all my fears. We are his walking witnesses who bear his testimony each day that we rise. Amen. The book of Revelation, John the Revelator said it like this, and they have overcome, conquered him by the means of the blood of the Lamb and the utterance of their testimonies, Minister Parker, for they did not love and cling to life even when faced with death, holding their lives cheap till they had to die for their witnessing. Trust in God, trust the Lord, even when life hurts, gives us the ability to have peace that's beyond understanding, Professor. So this morning, as we talk about we're blessed to be a blessing, we're blessed to be a blessing because we're trusting God to give us peace. We are trusting God to give us peace. The Bible says you will guard him and keep him in perfect peace and constant peace, whose mind, the Amplified said, both its inclination and its character is stayed on you because he commits himself to you, leans on you, and hopes confidently in you. So trust in the Lord. This morning, commit yourself to him, lean on him, hope confidently in him forever, for the Lord God is an everlasting rock. Professor, I think they used to call him the Rock of Ages. Amen. So trusting the Lord does not mean that we're living in some kind of delusional or denial state as to what's going on. No, it means that we choose to place whatever our problems are or whatever is going, the issues that we're facing in this upside down world before a right side up holy God. The Bible says, pour out all your worries and stresses upon him and leave them there, for he always tenderly cares for you. Don't fret or worry. Instead of worrying, pray. Let petitions and praises shape your worries into prayer, Brother Don, letting God know your concerns. Before you know it, a sense of God's wholeness and everything will be coming together for your good will come and settle you down. It's wonderful what happens when Christ displaces worry at the center of your life. That's why we live in such good cheer, people of God. You won't see us drooping our heads around or dragging our feet. You know, the conditions of this world we won't allow to get us down. They only remind us of what God has for us ahead. It's what we trust in, but don't yet see, that keeps us going through these times of despair. Do you suppose that a few ruts in the road or rocks on our path are gonna stop us? No. When the time comes, we'll be plenty ready to exchange this exile for a crown. Amen. We have decided to have faith in God's outcome to work things out on our behalf. Our faith is not in man. It's not in the president. It's not in the governor. It's not in CNN. It's not in our mayors. Our faith is in God. We're convinced that every detail of our lives is continually woven together to fit into God's perfect plan of bringing good into our lives. For we are his lovers who have been called to fulfill his designed purpose. Sometimes that means, Brother Don, that we will not get to do whatever it is that we thought we should be doing. But this is a time to trust in the Lord completely and do not rely on our own opinions. With all your heart, rely on him to guide you, and he will lead you in every decision you make. Become intimate with Holy Spirit in whatever you do, and he'll lead you wherever you go. Don't think for a moment that you know it all, for wisdom comes when you adore him with undivided devotion and avoid everything that is wrong. Yes, sometimes God says yes. Sometimes he says wait. Sometimes God even says no, Prophet Hawkins. But we have to trust God even when he says no. The steps of the God-pursuing ones follow firmly in the footsteps of the Lord. And God delights in every step that they take to follow him. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. The only way to truly follow God is to allow him to lead us through the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus said it like this, little children, you are of God, you belong to him, and have already defeated and overcome the world because of he who lives in you is greater, mightier than he who's in the world. I don't know about you, but that's good news to me this morning. That's good news because we know that God knows best. Amen. We know that we can trust his hand even when we can't trace him. We can trust his hand, and therefore we have to trust his plans. The Bible says, for I know the thoughts and plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Thoughts and plans for welfare and peace and not of evil, to give you hope and your final outcome. Amen. So we know that he always has our best interest at heart. Nobody knows, cares, or loves us more than the Lord. In this alone, we can take rest, even in the middle of social unrest, in the midst of a pandemic, we can have peace. So we're blessed to be a blessing because trusting in God gives us peace, but we're also blessed to be a blessing because trusting in God gives us joy. He who deals wisely and heeds God's word and counsel shall find good, and whoever leans on, trusts in, and is confident in the Lord is happy, blessed, and fortunate is he. Wow, that's good news. If you lean not to your own understanding, but heed to God's word and find wisdom in God's word and take your counsel from God's word and rely on the Holy Spirit and trust Holy Spirit, the word says that you'll be happy, blessed, and you'll be fortunate. Wow, sounds like the favor of God to me. So, that's such joyful encouragement this morning. And it's a joyful reminder that wise believers learn and receive God's word and apply it faithfully in their lives. You know, James said it best, we can't just be hearers of the word. We have to be doers. We have to start applying the word of God to our life. So during this season of pandemic, during this season of social unrest, during this season when the world is topsy-turvy, does the life that you live, and as we talked on last week, do your reactions to the actions of the world look like or line up with God's word? Amen. Jesus said it best. If you keep my commandments, you will live in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments, for I continually live nourished and empowered by his love. My purpose for telling you these things is so that the joy that I have experienced will fill your hearts with overflowing gladness. So this is my commandment. Love each other deeply as much as I have loved you. People of God, the world is walking around in a panic. The world is walking around in anger. We, as the people of God, have to come back. As Prophetess Tamikla prayed this morning in the opening prayer, We have to turn from our wicked ways, but we have to show the world love. What I hear it, Prophet Hawkins. The old song said, what the world needs now is love, love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. Right now, in the state of the world that we live in, the only thing that's going to turn back the hand of God is the love of God, and the love of God that's shown through the people of God, each and every person that's within the sound of my voice. For all the gods of the people are lifeless idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are found in his presence. Strength and joy are found in his sanctuary. This morning, I'm happy from the inside out and from the outside in. I'm firmly formed. You cancel my ticket to hell. That was my destination. Now you've got my feet on the life path, all radiant from the shining of your face. Ever since you took my hand, I'm on the right way. I don't know about anybody else in this line, but I'm glad that he picked me up, Prophet Hawkins, and he turned me around and he placed my feet on solid ground and put me on a rock to stay, because I was on my way to hell. But God, the Bible says, for his anger is but for a moment, but his favor is for a lifetime, or in his favor is for life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Jesus said it like this, but God will bless all who listen to the word of God and carefully obey everything they hear. But if you look carefully into the perfect law that sets you free, and if you do what it says, and don't forget what you heard, then God will bless you for doing it. So in other words, from obedience, blessing flows. Blessings of joy, peace, hope, grace, and mercy. In the English Standard Translation of the Bible, the word joy or joyful appears a total of 430 times, Brother Martin, compared to the word happy or happiness, which appears only 10 times. And I asked God, what are you trying to tell your people this morning? God is saying this. The world is looking to be happy, but that's why they're in topsy-turvy, because I'm looking to give you joy. And if you have joy, you don't have to worry about happiness. You're going to catch that later on. But joy. You know, the word happiness only appears 10 times. So joy is lasting, and it satisfies the heart in a unique and marvelous way. Joy is a characteristic of God's people that's only found in his presence, Bishop Rush. Christian joy flows from realizing our position in Christ, who you are in him, what he has done for you, and who he is in you. I don't know about anybody else, but one of the things that I'm most joyful about is my position in God. If God were to take away everything from me, the thing that I would not want him to take away is my position in him and his position in me. Amen. The sorrow and suffering of this pandemic will pass, but joy continues in spite of the hardships we face as a result of this season of transformation. Season of transformation, Pastor Don, what are you saying? I'm saying this, people of God. Yes, this is a strange season. We've never passed this way before. But I admonish you this morning that this thing is not catching God by surprise. God knows the way it started. God knows when it's going to be over. God knows what it's going to be like on the other side. So during this season, the people of God need to be transformed. We need to transform our mind to have a mind like Christ Jesus. In other words, you can't go to the football stadium. You can't go to the movies. You can't go to all these other places that occupied your time. So I admonish you, get yourself back in position with God. Get yourself back to where Minister Ezekiel, where you are re-communing with Holy Spirit the way you did when you first fell in love with him. Amen. So use this season of pandemic as a season of transformation. God, what is it that you're trying to tell me in this season? What is it that you are trying to get me to understand, Sister Dodie? You know, our faith in Jesus transfers God's righteousness to us, and he now declares us flawless in his eyes. In other words, he's thrown our sins behind us as far as the east is from the west. This means that we can enjoy true and lasting peace with God, all because of what Jesus, the anointed one, has done for us on a hill called Calvary. It all goes back to the redemptive work on the cross. We already have the victory. Our faith guarantees us permanent access to this marvelous kindness that has given us a perfect relationship with God. What incredible joy bursts forth within us as we keep on celebrating our hope of experiencing God's glory. Who is this? The hope of glory. But that's not all. Even in times of trouble, we have a joyful confidence, people of God, knowing that our pressures will develop us in patient endurance. And patient endurance will refine our character. And proven character leads us back to hope. And this hope is not a disappointing fantasy like the world, because we can now experience the endless love of God cascading into our hearts through Holy Spirit who lives in each and every one of us. Have you spoken to Holy Spirit today? Have you talked to him? Have you communed with Holy Spirit? So, people of God, we're blessed to be blessings. As men and women of God, as I conclude this morning, I just stop by on this line. I just stopped by on this Zoom to tell each and every person within the sound of my voice, even though the curve of the pandemic is rising each day, even though the states are contemplating shutting down again, even though we can't get into the church building, even though there's no vaccine developed yet, even though the 2020 election is now turning into a mockery, I just stopped by this morning to tell you that as believers of God, that each and every one of you are blessed to be a blessing. And we know that we're blessed to be a blessing because trusting in God gives us peace. But we know that we're blessed to be a blessing because trusting in God gives us joy. Peace and joy, not as the world gives us, but the kind of peace and joy that can only come from living the word of God. Jesus said it like this: so you will pass through a time of intense sorrow when I'm taken from you, but you will see me again. And then your hearts will burst with joy with no one being able to take me from you. And that's good news, that the Holy Spirit lives inside of each and every one of you. Unlike happiness, which is only a temporary emotion, but joy is pure satisfaction. Joy. Several times God's word describes joy as full or complete. Joy satisfies the heart in a way that temporary happiness never can. Jesus said, if you keep my commands, you live in my love, just as I've kept my Father's commands, for I continually live, nourished, and empowered by his love. My purpose for telling you these things this morning is so that the joy that I have experienced will fill your hearts with overflowing gladness. Throughout the Old and New Testaments, the fullness of joy is found in the presence of the Lord. Splendor and majesty flow out of him. Strength and joy fill his place. So even in the midst of everything that we're facing this morning, remember, people of God, that we're blessed to be a blessing. Hallelujah. God's word provides us with the guidance for each, for this very situation that the world is facing this morning on July 12, 2020, and any other trials that are present in our life. Praise God and his holy word for his love, for his peace, for his joy, for his mercy, for his grace, for his goodness. So as I conclude this morning, let me leave you with this morning. During this time of lockdown with God, let us spend more time in his book than on Facebook, because the rim of heaven's kingdom is about to appear. So you better keep turning away from evil and turn back to God. For that time, Jesus began to preach, crying out, repent, change your mind for the better, heartily amend your ways for the abhorrence of your past sins, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. His message was, at the last fulfillment of the age has come. It is time for the realm of God's kingdom to be experienced in its fullness. Turn your lives back to God and put your trust in the hope-filled gospel. For the kingdom of God is not a matter about food or drink, but it's about the realm of Holy Spirit, filled with righteousness, joy, and peace. So people of God, remember that you're blessed to be a blessing. You're blessed to be a blessing because you can trust in God and receive his peace. You're blessed to be a blessing because as you trust in God, hallelujah, you receive his joy. Joy not as the world can give you. This world didn't give it to you, and the world can't take it away. But remember, you're blessed to be a blessing in Jesus' name. Father God, we come to you this morning. We thank you, and we decree and declare that we are your people, and you are our God. And God, we won't look to the left, we won't look to the right, but during this time of refocus on you, that God, we will keep our eyes focused on Jesus. We won't be like Peter and take our eyes off of you, God, because God, we know that during this season of transformation, that you are in our boat. You said in your word that you never leave us and never forsake us. So God, allow us to refocus on you and to look at what's going on in the world through the lens of Jesus, not as the world looks at it, but the lens of Jesus. And God, we repent for not allowing Holy Spirit to guide us. God, you said in your word for us to lean not to our own understanding, acknowledge you in all we do, and that you would direct our path. So God, we ask this morning that you, God, that you be our divine GPS during this season of uncertainty. God, that we will only go where you tell us to go. We'll only do what you tell us to do. And God, that during this season of uncertainty, that we will put on the love of Jesus and we will be blessed to be blessings to others. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Pastor Paulette, I now yield the call to you.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, for that everlasting joy, everlasting peace, everlasting hope, even the overflowing gladness that's been released in our hearing on today. We thank you, God. My nugget that I pulled was that we be walking witnesses of your transforming power. We thank you that we give you access to dwell with us, to dwell in us, to dwell among us, to abide and to cause your presence to be in our midst. Your presence is the place where we have access to so much. So we thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. What I want to do right here, we don't take it for granted that everyone knows the Lord. So we want to give you this opportunity to recommit, to first and foremost, to dedicate your life to the Lord. Or maybe you've known him, life has happened even in the midst of what we're walking through and you stepped away, but God was always right there. This is a time for you to rededicate your life fresh and anew unto the Lord. And so at this time, we want, if you don't know Jesus and the pardon of your sins, if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus, let me tell you, there's some benefits that come from this. The number one benefit is when you accept Jesus as your Savior, you get the all three of them, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You get the Holy Spirit that leads you, guides you, instructs you, directs you, corrects you, talks to you. He makes you become the dwelling place. He helps you in this transforming time. So God, we thank you and praise you for those that are saying yes to your Son for the very first time, those that are recommitting themselves unto you in this time and in this season. If that's you, if you're on the line or watching this YouTube, email us at pauletx7@gmail.com. Let us know that you have rededicated your life or committed your life to the Lord, and we'll be sure to contact you and help you know and understand this relationship that you have said yes to and step forward in at this time. God, we thank you for everyone that's on the line. So at this time, I want to call up just a few people. We're trying new technology, and so we're just going to call three people to come forward and share on the line. The first one, Prophet Hawkins, I would like for you to come forward and share and end with prayer of what you've heard us say. And after Prophet Hawkins, Minister Vanessa will call you to unmute your phone. So Prophet Hawkins, if you can come up first. All right. Prophet Hawkins, you there? Glory to God. I'm seeing calls drop. All right. Are we being heard in the phone? Let me make sure we're still being heard. Hello? Yep. All right. Minister Vanessa, are you available?
Sorry.
Okay, there go Hawkins. So Hawkins, you go first. Go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry. My phone was acting crazy. Thank you. With on the name hearing, praise God. I'm supporting my brother. And God for update. Journey in the Lord is calling for his people to stand. We thank God for the community this morning. Awesome word, my brother. God is calling us to deeper depth and greater heights. So we praise God for you. You guys are just proclaiming the holiness of God on this Lord's Day. So I was blessing this morning. I'm doing a lot moving this morning. You know, we're selling and we're just moving. God, but the prayer from my grandbaby, forgive me for not being in depth this morning, but I did enjoy what I heard. So, Father, we thank you for your word. We bless you and magnify you. We bless you today. Father, continue to bless your servants, your vessels. Honor, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Lord God, we pray that you would continue to pour your word in them, Lord God, and to encourage your people. We thank you, Lord God, for the stand that they're making, Lord, that they will stand, continue to stand in holiness, and we'll be careful to give your name the praise. We'll be so careful to give you all of your glory in Jesus' name. May the words of our mouth and the meditations of the heart be pleasing and acceptable in your sight, O Lord, O God, our strength and our Redeemer, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, my sister, for the opportunity.
Amen. Thank you so much, Prophet Hawkins. Minister Vanessa Parker, Wisdom Pearls, you can come off mute.
Good morning, Pastor Don and Sister Paulette. God bless you.
Good
well,
morning.
The word today was very fulfilling. The word that I pulled from was to trust God. He said to trust God, trust him, commit to him. It said when we trust him, sometimes we don't see him. We just got to continue to trust him, and we must trust the Lord completely. I heard the pastor talk this morning about trusting God's plan and trusting in God will give us joy. And that's what we're searching for, joy, unspeakable joy. And even when Pastor Don said, we are in a season of transformation, he said that this pandemic has nothing on God because God knew when it started and God knows when it will end. That we have to trust him through everything. But he said something so profound, but the joy of the Lord is our strength. He told us to turn our lives back to God, repent. He said to mend our ways and trust God. He said, you are blessed to be a blessing. You two was a blessing in my life years ago, Pastor Don, when I first met you guys. It's just been a blessing. And I want to thank you for the opportunity to not only just hear the word, but to commune with you on this beautiful Sunday morning. Amen. God bless you.
Mute. All right. Wow. Thank you so much, Vanessa. You know what? Let me do a prayer break right here. I heard two things that I need to pray for, two people that are still on the line. I want to catch you before you have to get off of work. And so we're praying for Chantel for continued healing in her body. And then we're also praying for Brother Martin. Tomorrow is his birthday. So God, we thank you for the community of believers that you have brought together here at Double Portion Kingdom Ministries. And it's not just Sunday morning at 7 o'clock, but we pray over each and every person that calls in on this line. So we're lifting up Brother Martin as he is celebrating one more year of life on tomorrow. Thank you for causing our paths to cross and allowing him to be connected with us. He's in Mexico. We're in Houston, Texas, and Chicago, and in Minneapolis, different places on the line, but we're praying for the brotherhood. So thank you for blessing him to do and be everything that you've created him to be. We lift up Sister Chantel. She's over there in Louisiana, and we thank you for your healing virtue that is with her, even as she's going through these formed weapon of sickness and disease, and even the voice of pain that's trying to speak loud. We decree and declare healing virtue be released on this morning and every day that we are yet alive in the land of the living. Let our faith be stronger than the trials that we're walking through. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and bless God. Well, I have time for two more people. I'm not going to call by name. If you are on the line, let me see. I have a couple of phones muted because of noise. But if you are on the line and you would like to come forward at this time, the line is now open. Amen. Is there anyone else on the line that would like to come forward?
Yes. Hello.
Okay, we're going to have Professor and then Ezekiel and then Martin. Go right ahead. Professor first. Go ahead.
Good morning, everyone. What a great message this morning, as always. And he said to God is always the same today and forevermore. Be content with who we are in the Lord, and we'll find joy. Isaiah says, don't panic. Be confident in who we are. That we have seen time after time, God has been with us. He has never left us nor forsaken us. He has always been there for us. Trust God, he said, no matter what's going on around us, just trust him to give us peace, joy. A lot of us be looking for happiness. But God doesn't care if we're happy or not. God wants us to be joyful in the Lord. Commit ourselves to him, knowing he will always be there because he cares for us. What I liked, what I really like, he said, become intimate with Holy Spirit. And I said, I think last week that you know, the Holy Spirit has been looked over so many times, but he emphasized this morning, become intimate with Holy Spirit. Trust Holy Spirit to help us to be a blessing. God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we just thank you for that word. We thank you for the deliverer of that word this morning. Father God, both he and Pastor Paulette, having given us such a wonderful word this morning, and that there's such wonderful prayers to lift us up as we travel along our way. Father God, we are going through a pandemic. But oh God, we just thank you for our leaders on this line, who every Sunday morning, they come to us with words, uplifting words and with their hearts still full of love, leading and guiding us every week after week after week. And God, we just thank you for them. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you, oh God, for wrapping your arms around each one of us this morning, oh Father God. Bless everyone on this line. All of us are going through something, oh God. But help us, oh God, to go through, holding to your unchanging hand, continuously building our hopes on things eternal, but continuously holding to your unchanging hand. It's the only hand we have to hold that we know will never change. We can lean, we can depend on you for everything we need. You said in Philippians 4:19 that you would supply our every need. And not one time have I ever looked for something or needed something, and you didn't bring it, you didn't send it. Holy Spirit was always there, helping us to climb higher mountains. And God, we just thank you this morning. Keep us, oh God. Shield us, oh God. Protect us, oh God. We know how much you love us. Thank you, God. Praise you, honor and glorify you. Back to you, Pastor Paulette.
Amen. Thank you, Professor. Go ahead and put your phone on mute. Ezekiel, you were next.
Amen. Good morning, brother and sisters.
Good morning.
What an awesome morning. Very awesome morning. Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all I have.
Zeke, come closer to your phone. You're fading out.
Okay.
Okay, that's
can
better.
Can you hear me now?
That's much better. Go right ahead.
You hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Trust in the Lord, lean not in our own understanding. And all our ways acknowledge the Lord. What a powerful word. I mean, we know that without trust in God, we can do nothing. We can be nothing because in him we have our being, and without him, we can do nothing. It's just like the car that we drive daily. If we know that car don't have gas or spark plugs or good tires, what it needs is senseless is to move. We know that we can't go down the street. We can't go out of town. We can't go to the job. But we put our trust that this car is going to work right because things are needed, that's needed in the car is working properly. God is the vehicle in life that we need. And we know that when we trust in him, he's going to direct our path and put us on the path of righteousness and keep us on the path of righteousness. Consecration is a daily thing. Wow, communion is a daily thing, but God calls us to do it collectively so that we can apply our faith, so that we can be in one accord and union. But it's a daily thing, just like the children of Israel had to be holier. God is calling us to be holy as he is holy. And it's daily. It's daily. It's daily that we seek God. It's daily that we have to gas up the car. It's daily that we have to check the car to make sure it runs properly. So we have to check ourselves daily that we're in place where God wants us to be at. Because we don't want to get out of place, not God. God is always in place. He's always running 100%. Everything is always perfect in God. And that's why he tells us that the mind of us in Christ also be within us. That's why he says, set your affections above where Christ sees at the right hand of the Father. So that's why daily we have to consecrate ourselves. Daily we have to trust in the Lord. And we have to put ourselves in remembrance of these things. And this is just an awesome word, just an awesome word this morning. And I'm humbled because God is calling me personally to evaluate myself daily. Because there are so many challenges that we all face, even this pandemic that we're going through. We're not going to make it on our own. We're not going to make it making our own decisions. We have to trust in the Lord, as Pastor Don was saying, and lean not on our own understanding. We have to acknowledge that God knows what we don't know. He sees what we don't see. He protects us from things that we don't even know of. That's what the word says. So daily, as we walk in consecration, daily, as we trust in the Lord, daily, as we put our mind on Christ and set our affections above, God is going to make sure that we know what we need to know at that right appointed time. So this word is just to bless me this morning, and I pray that it bless all others. And Father, I just want to give you glory this morning because your word is ever true. Your word is always moving. Your word is always fresh, and yes and amen. Your word does what you have sent it forth to do, and it never returns void and never will. And I just pray on my part for total obedience. I just pray for total consecration. I just pray that the mind of Christ within Christ Jesus would also be within me and every brother, every sister who loves the Lord. I pray that you call us and that we hear and that we obey and that we run quickly to do what you have called us to be. Father, where we have fallen short, I ask that you would give us grace to walk in true repentance and to turn around from everything that be not of you, everything that hinders us from hearing what the Spirit of God is saying to us. Holy Spirit, if we grieve you in any way, if I grieve you in any way, I repent. And I'm asking you, Holy Spirit, to teach us, to uphold us, to direct us, to cause us to monitor the wings as eagles to run and not grow weary, to walk and not faint. Lord, let your trust be ever true in our heart, like a resounding bell that we hear continually. Let us be mindful of the things of Christ. Let us count it all joy and run the race. Let us put ourselves in remembrance daily. Let us encourage ourselves, Father, and help us to know, most importantly, when we don't understand, that's even greater, should be even greater motive and effort on our part to trust in you and to know that you said that your word, you're doing what you said you would do and that we don't have to fear, because he's not giving us a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. He's not a God that lies, but you're a God of yea and amen. You're a God that answers prayer, and you're a God that chastises and corrects those you love. And all this is trusting in you. So, Father, have your way in us. Be our God. We submit to you. We love you. We ask you for more. And we just give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Brother Martin, you'll be our last speaker. Come up now, Brother Martin.
Yes. Hello, can you hear me?
I hear you now. Go right ahead.
Okay. All right, well, that was a joyful word for today. I mean, it came together and just hit the spot. You know, I mean, as you mentioned it, tomorrow, it's my birthday. I'm 31 years old. You know, it was just a word that hit the spot. You know, it was right on time. And I just see these times as that we're going through right now. You know, everybody's being affected by what's going on right now, the pandemic. And it's just, you know, when Pastor Don was saying about the rift, you know, it's like, it seems like that's what's going on right now. We're in the rift, you know, and if we keep our eyes on Christ, you know, even though we're going through these pandemics and through all these things that it's affecting people, you know, we got to keep our eyes on them instead of looking to, you know, getting distracted and not being able to focus on Christ, you know. So, that's what I feel like, you know, today's word, that's what it was telling me, you know, to focus on Christ, you know, even though everything that's going on is a distraction, but we got to keep our eyes on him, you know. So I was just blessed by the word immensely today. So Heavenly Father, I just thank you, Lord, for the word that you brought forward today, Father. I thank you, Father, for keeping us in good health, Father, my family and I, and everybody online, Father. I just thank you, Father, for the opportunity that you brought forward today, Father, for helping us to fellowship online and learning and growing together, Father. I thank you, Father, for giving me another year of life, Father, and for blessing me and keeping me strong and in your word, Father. I ask you, Father, to continue to lead me, Father, and help me to lead my family as well, Father. And I just I pray, Father, and thank you for the major blessing that Pastor Don and Pastor Paulette have been in our lives, Father. And I continue to ask you to bless them and bless these nine, Father, so that we can continue to grow together, Father. I pray for my Aunt Erica, Father, and I just ask, Father, that you continue to give her the strength, Father, to continue to fight for through this virus, Father. And I pray for these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Brother Martin. Happy 31st birthday. The other thing that I want everyone on the line to know, that even in this season, one of the things that you can do in your home is worship God. That's one of the reasons why we incorporate worship into what we do. So on today, we've listened to the anthem by Todd Delaney, knowing that, you know, hallelujah, you've won the victory. It's a done data. And when you put those songs on, it kind of waters the word that's already been sown. And then let the church say amen, knowing that it's done. And then it's love that Jesus went to Calvary. That's love. And we're going to close for today with Kiara Sheard's new song, that something has to break. When you press into God's presence like this, when you press in the midst of a pandemic, when you are the dwelling place for Holy Spirit, something got to break. Something has to break. Jesus. So I'm going to pray and yield to Pastor Don to close us out, and we'll release with the music. So God, we thank you that everything we've heard on today, that it finds the good ground of our heart, that it produces some 30, 60, 100-fold, better yet, kingdom-fold for your glory, that you get the glory, the honor, and the praise out of each and every one of your servants on Double Portion Kingdom Ministries. We thank you for all that you've done, you're going to do, in Jesus' name. Amen. Pastor Don?
Can you go ahead and raise your hands for me? I'd like each and every person, wherever you are, to raise your hands so that you can receive the priestly blessing this morning. Amen. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, speak this to Aaron and to his sons. So we're going to declare the priestly blessings over everybody who stayed on the line until the end of the call. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In Jesus' name, shalom. Go in peace, walk in faith, and walk in favor. And remember that you are blessed to be a blessing. Amen.
Shalom. Amen.
Feel it in his flow. Holy Spirit knows when you have your way, something has to break. Tear down every lie, set the wrong thing right. Cause when you have your way, something has to break. Something has to break. Right now in your name, something has to break. Something has to break. Hey, right now in your name, something has to break. Oh, I believe you'll get me to rest. I believe you'll lead me through it. I believe that you will do it right now. Something has to break.
I believe you'll lead me through it. I believe
you'll
get me through it.
I believe
that you will do it right now. Something has to break.
I believe
you'll lead me through it.
I believe.
We
You've been waiting for a long time.